What's up, everybody? CHM Carnivores here. I am so excited about this video. I actually stumbled across the answer to this question by accident. Now, there's been a lot of debate, as long as I've been in the carnivorous plant community, of whether or not you can bring dead sphagnum moss back to life. And the answer might shock you. So there's been a back and forth. Some people say absolutely, some say absolutely not. And then I haven't really seen any videos that give definitive proof. But I'm going to show you today how you could do that. How you can take dead sphagnum moss and bring it back to life, and what you need to do in order to do that, and what you need to buy in order to do that. So just like anything else with carnivorous plants, the answer is a little complicated, but I think I'm going to be able to show you how to do it and help you be able to purposefully do something that I accidentally stumbled upon. All that and more coming your way. See you in just a minute. What you're looking at here is live sphagnum moss. Now, the crazy thing about this, if you'll remember my video I did on seedlings, here are the seedlings, so maybe a little update for you as well on that. I talked about how the sphagnum moss, there's also a different type of moss in here, but how the sphagnum moss surprisingly grew back. Now, I've been watching a lot of videos trying to find that, right? And if you've seen some of my videos in the past, you'll see moss here and there. I've never purchased live sphagnum moss. You can certainly do that. It can be a little pricey, and it may or may not survive the travel. But in order to get this to happen, in order to get this to grow, was actually very easy. And I'm going to show you how to do it just now. But the first thing I need to tell you is, I think it depends on the quality of moss. Now, you can buy the real expensive New Zealand sphagnum moss online, and I'm pretty sure that will not come back to life. They do a very good job of treating that and heat treating it, and it kills the spores. Because you see this is growing, you can probably guess what I'm going to say is I did not buy the high quality stuff, but I'm going to show you what I did buy. Let me go out of frame for a minute here. What I got is this right here from Lowe's. Now, this comes in two different varieties. There's a more refined version of it, and that is for a orchid moss. This is a bigger, long sphagnum fiber moss. That is very hard to say. But what was really cool about this, it's about $6. Both of them are about $6. The smaller one that's more refined, you pay the same price for a smaller quantity. But in this case, I'm finding that the lesser quality, if you will, seems to be the better variety for growing live sphagnum moss. And so this is what I've used, and this is what I've had success on nearly every single time I've tried this. And I think it's because it is just more of a cheaper moss that they don't treat as well. Now, there are a few drawbacks to this. One being you have some nut grass in here that you have to deal with because it doesn't kill everything. But the other thing is this one does not hold up as well when you're using it as a media. So if you are going to go a media route, you're probably going to want to mix this with a heavy amount of perlite, or go with a more fancy, more expensive sphagnum moss that has been treated better. But if for the purposes of today's video, this will do just fine. Now, let me show you the second thing I did. I'm going to pull this tray back out. Now, I've got several of these trays where it's been growing over, but you'll notice in here, if I can get the camera to view, that it is not alive down here. And so what this is, I got these off of Amazon, very cheap. They're just seedling trays. And if you'll remember from the seedling video, it's got a cover that sits over it with a little ventilation. So what I did was I took, and it has little individual compartments, and all I did was simply take some of that dead sphagnum moss and stuff it down in there nice and tight. And then I chopped up the sphagnum moss on top to be more of a finely milled so that the seedlings wouldn't get covered. I don't know that that's necessarily important for what we're trying to do today, but it has borne results for the seedlings. They're looking beautiful. And so then what I did was I placed this in. It comes with a little green tray that it sits in, and I poured water in there and had it nice and saturated, very well soaked. And I put that lid on there, and I kept the lid ventilation completely closed. Now, this had been sitting basically as a dead brown moss for 2-3 weeks. And then I started noticing something very cool, very unique. And it started growing not only green, but also red sphagnum moss, which is very, very neat. Now, I kept the ventilation closed for about 2 to 3 weeks for the seeds, but I think that also helped the moss. And as far as lighting, I kept it about 4 feet to 5 feet away. So it was getting probably what would be the equivalent of a 60% shade at all times. Now, I'm going to show you a different moss where it's actually growing, where I took some of this and it's actually growing in a pot. So I'm going to pause the video, turn the camera around and show you that it will survive out of this condition. Give me 1 second. So just in case you're thinking, well, yes, it's great. It lives, but it's only going to last if it's in that condition. You can see here, this is my, Ime, and it is growing just fine in here. Now with your moss, if you start to see this browning, that is because the tips are drying out. That's going to die, but what will come underneath it is more moss. And so I've got some there. There's some that's doing okay down here. Just throughout the pots, really, there's some other types of moss, but in general, it will stay in here. So here's another pot. Let me grab here, right down here. Here's some, see it in there. It's growing. Now, remember, I've never purchased any sphagnum moss. We've got some more here as well that is growing with my seedlings. Moss is funny, especially sphagnum moss. Probably if this would be a drinking game, you'd be drinking every time I said sphagnum moss, but it's finicky. It will dry out very easily. So it kind of likes a more, I wouldn't say shaded area, but certainly not direct sun. And I've got a fan going, which I'm sure you hear. So you want to try to keep it out of that fan's way, but certainly it grows really well and it lasts. So these things have not had covers on them. I've been trying to harden up the seedlings for probably 3-4 weeks, maybe 2 months. And it has stayed alive and I don't have an overhead sprayer or anything like that. So it is simply staying alive just by being in this greenhouse. And there's nothing special happening in here. I don't have any overhead sprayer systems or anything like that. So here is some of the red that has grown. That has since not lasted all of it, but there, I can't get it out of, let me get this out of the way. There's some doing just fine there. And it is throughout the entire area. If I probably can't see it over there, but there's some in there and it is spreading out all over the place. Let me turn the camera around and we'll talk a little bit more. So the point of this quick video is to show you that with a little time and with patience, you can in fact grow live sphagnum moss from dead sphagnum moss. Now again, remember, if you buy the really high-end New Zealand stuff, that's probably not going to grow for you. And if you want to use that, I would probably use that more for your bottom media. And if you're looking to try this little experiment that I did rather accidentally, then I would buy some of the more cheaper variety. Again, you get this from big box stores. You can get it on Amazon, but it is this Better Grow, about $6 for this bushel. And remember, moss like this expands quite a bit, so this will go a long ways. And if you want to have it just sort of a seed collection, not says seeds as far as seeds, but just have something that you can sort of decorate your pots and let it continue to take over, I would leave it in those little trays that I was talking about. And then take the lid off and just slowly pick it out and put it in your different pots as you grow them. And then just keep that spreading. Let's face it, it looks beautiful when there's just that moss that's growing around your tropical plants. As far as difficulty, 0 out of 10, not difficult at all. Now, I have seen people try to grow it with the tray method where you put like an egg crate down on a tray and keep that water in. That seems to be a little bit more difficult. But again, this would be something that I would naturally do anyways, just trying to grow seedlings. And so the difficulty was none because I wasn't expecting any of it to happen. And so if you take that approach, less is more, set it and forget it, just like the old commercials. And in a couple of weeks, maybe to a month, you'll have the start of some sphagnum moss. I hope you've enjoyed this video. It is quick. There's not a lot to it, and I don't want to sit there and just drag it out for the sake of dragging it out. I'd like to be conscientious of your time and be able to get you what you need quickly. I hope that you've enjoyed this video, and if you have, please, as always, like and subscribe, and get the word out there. Hit the like button. That makes a huge difference. Get the word out to as many people as possible. Thank you so much for your support. We just hit 3,000, which is amazing. Thank you so much for that. And we're going to continue to grow this community. And I very much love and enjoy reading your comments. Continue to do that and interact. And let's just continue to grow these plants together. Have a wonderful day and a wonderful week. I'll see you soon.